Let's move to Secretary of State Hillary Clinton. She finishes up her final weeks as America's top diplomat and has to, of course, contemplate her next move. Clinton world is not exactly sitting quietly, though. New York Times kicked off what is likely to become a monthly exercise by somebody in the media, trust us. Hillary Watch. We may even come up with a meter. Probably throw in Jeb in there, right? We should call it the Hillary Jebatron version 2016. Probably John Stewart starting that up already. But anyway, with the spread over the weekend, the New York Times reporter Jody Kantor interviewed a number of Clinton aides about her future plans, and strikingly, a lot of them talked. While Clinton has dozens of options when she leaves the State Department, Kantor makes this smart observation. She has a big constraint. The more serious she is about 2016, the less she can do. No frank, seen-it-all memoir, no clients, commissions, or controversial positions that could prove problematic in either the 2016 primaries or the general. Instead, Kantor reports that Secretary Clinton is considering writing an upbeat look at her time as Secretary of State, not a painful examination of her failed 2008 bid, as she once proposed. Likely to be quoted in such a book, a handful of Clinton aides who were willing to go on the record with the Times, even when asked questions that made it clear the paper was doing a story on Clinton's presidential ambitions. Ann Lewis, a longtime senior advisor to the Clintons and one to Hillary's campaign in 2008, tells the paper, in the last 4 years, she has seen firsthand the difference she can make for women and girls, and that could be the focus of some such book on women's rights around the world. State Department spokesman Philippe Rhines, quote, nobody interacts with Hillary Clinton like she's fading off into the sunset. And aides talk to the paper on background about the timing, strategy, even the issue she might focus on in a future one. Then there's the friend of Bill Clinton who tells the Times he sometimes cannot keep himself from verbally gaming out another campaign for her, whether she wants it or not, saying every indication is that he would really want her to run. The enthusiasm from Clinton world hit a fever pitch on Sunday when Bill Clinton buddy, Democratic strategist James Carville, was asked about the 2016 bid.
Every Democrat I know says, God, I hope she runs. We don't need a primary. The Democrats wanted to run. And I don't just mean a lot of Democrats. I mean a whole lot of Democrats, like 90% across the country.
In a GW Politico battleground poll out this morning, Hillary Clinton's favorable rating is at 60%, higher than the president's and higher than Vice President Biden's. She's also more popular than the Republicans tested, who may be laying the groundwork for 2016, Paul Ryan, Jeb Bush, and Marco Rubio. By the way, Newt Gingrich said Sunday on Meet the Press that what makes her such a formidable opponent.
If their competitor in 16 is going to be Hillary Clinton, supported by Bill Clinton and presumably a still relatively popular President Barack Obama, trying to win that will be truly the Super Bowl. And the Republican Party today is incapable of competing at that level.
So should we do our little meter every week? Do you want us to do it every day? Go ahead and tweet me some advice. How do we deal with Hillary Watch 2016? If you want it daily, let us know. If you want it weekly, if you need a break, you're not going to get a break. The question is daily or weekly, and we're going to throw Jeb into that mix as well. All right. Well, they are, won't they? It's a 2016 speculation game that's never going to go away, well, at least until the filing deadline for the New Hampshire primary. And it's running high right now for both Hillary Clinton and Chris Christie. And they both try to downplay their prospects for running for the White House in interviews with ABC's Barbara Walters.
What would it take to convince you to run in 2016?
You know, that's all hypothetical because right now I have no intention of running.
How do you think you're going to feel in 2016?
Well, you know what? I have no idea.
Knowing that she gets these interviews. Joining me now, MSNBC contributor and editor of PostPolitics.com, Chris Elizon, Politico senior political reporter, Jonathan Martin. I have to say,
a lot of peace.
You know, no, it is a lot of P's. You've got to be careful not to pop your P's. You know, it's funny, Barbara Walters gets these interviews.
She does.
No, it's not news. I'm doing a fascinating thing. I'm doing a holiday special.
And they all sucker
in for it because, you know, it's a way to talk to a non-political audience. But listening, Hillary Clinton's response was, to me, rather interesting and I think more honest than people realize. Yeah, she's more undecided on this than I think folks realize.
Yeah, everybody you talk to around Hillary says that if you asked her right now, I'd probably inclined not to do it. But what they always say after that is, if you ask her a year from now, after she has...
They hope that after the rest and all this stuff that
she's too exhausted.
Right.
But after she's been down for a year, and you're waking up, and it's Tuesday morning, and you're in Chappaqua, you don't have anything to do, anywhere to go, for a while that's fun, and that is very much enjoyable after you've been working as hard as she has.
Right.
But at some point, when you're as passionate about politics and public service as the Clintons are, you have to wonder what's next.
But Chris, if I told you in December of 2008 that by the end of 2012, the two most popular Democrats in the country in the final NBC Wall Street Journal poll would both be the name of Clinton. Look at this. Look at the positive rating. Bill Clinton, 60-24. Talk about a recovery. Hillary Clinton, 58-28. If you can't beat him, join him, right? Which is sort of what Bill Clinton decided to do, and he went all in for Obama in a way that I don't think anybody thought was possible even a year ago.
I feel like their both of their kind of roller coasters of popularity in some way is why people like the three of us can never just say, yeah, she's probably done, because there's something about them that just draws you back
it's not just reporters.
No, really. it's the public. And the one thing I would say too about her, Jonathan and I, we've all talked about this. I always think the best indicator of whether you might run for president again is you've run for president before. It's the Carvel.
Yeah.
You never lose that fire. That's why I would say, just, it's not really talking about it, but Biden is the same way. I don't know that we rule out Joe Biden. The guy's run for president twice before in his own right.
Let's bring back the gaggle. Former Senator Blaine Lincoln, Alfonso Aguilar, and Liz Sidoti. All right, Senator Lincoln, I got to ask you this. Arkansas native, you heard Hillary Clinton's response. How believable was it to you?
Well, you know, I don't...
You always believe a Clinton's going to run for something, don't you? Are you conditioned like that in Arkansas?
You kind of are, but I think she did such an incredible job before. Obviously, I was an early supporter of Senator Clinton when she ran, and I think she's done an incredible job as Secretary of State.
Can you underestimate the movement aspect that there would be, first woman, that this time there would... Do you think it would be the real coronation that everybody miscalculated 8 years ago?
Well, just look at the polls, though, you're putting out about women and what they're thinking about. They want somebody that's practical and pragmatic, and it's going to be compromising and work to get results. And I mean, women are kind of getting over the top in these polls about let's get real here about getting the job done.
All right. It's way too early to talk about 2016. I think I did mention that I have a warm regard for the people of Iowa and New Hampshire.
Plenty of party favorites are already flirting with the 2016 run, but let's be honest. There's one potential dynasty do-over that dominates the early moves in both parties. Let's bring back the gaggle. Crystal is a Perry Bacon, Stephanie Cutter, and Kevin Madden. I look at this and say, it's Bush, it's Clinton, it's for all the marbles, it's the rematch. If we don't get Jeb and Hillary, Chris, what are we going to do with ourselves?
I mean,
I
love good primaries.
I love great generals more.
Yeah.
Come on.
Yeah, I mean, this would be like that time when you were like, what if Hillary Clinton ran for the Senate, and what if Rudy Giuliani ran against, you know, that
no, honestly,
that
it could be, I think it's the only thing it's we've ever had close to it would be Kennedy Nixon.
Right, a
where
huge,
you had
the two
stars,
titanic
right.
figures
titanic
of the party. You know, the thing I would say is I actually think it is not too far-fetched to think that could happen. I think if Hillary Clinton run, I find it hard to believe that the Andrew Cuomos and Martin O'Malley's of the world stay in. Less clear that Jeb clears out a primary, but he's the kind of ideological, the guy who can mash the conservatives and the kind of establishment. I mean,
it's the purists versus the pragmatists, whether or not...
Well, Jeb is the guy that could bridge
hybrid.
The divide.
Correct.
Let me ask you this, Stephanie. It's not clear to me that Clinton is the natural heir to the Obama coalition. Is it to you? Is she?
You know, I think that there is no natural heir. People want you to earn it. And I think that there's no argument out there that she hasn't earned it. She has. And, you know, I think that she has done remarkably well as the Secretary of State. And who was talking about it earlier, Kevin was, that when she speaks, everybody in this country listens.
Yeah,
you know, she is a voice of authority on so many issues. And also, this is the year of the woman.
Yeah, it is. It's going to happen. And Perry, here's the two most popular figures we tested in our last NBC Wall Street Journal poll. Both were named Clinton. The number three was Obama.
Hillary Clinton is ending her job as the Secretary of State, but if history is any guide, we're not going to be seeing the last of her by any means. CNN's Randy Kaye is joining us. She's got some details. Randy, tell our viewers what's going on.
Well, Wolf, as you know, there was quite a bit of drama playing out on Capitol Hill today. You saw it yourself. At times, Hillary Clinton close to tears. Other times, she looked pretty enraged. But drama and controversy, certainly nothing new for her. She has seen it all. This is not the first time Hillary Clinton seemed to say goodbye.
I am determined to leave the State Department and our country safer, stronger, and more secure.
When you just knew she'd be back to say hello. She launched herself back in the days of the nerdy circular glasses as the woman who could take tradition and crack it like a nut. She and Bill Clinton met and fell in love at Yale. Then in 1974, she moved to Arkansas to teach, making partner at the Rose Law Firm 5 years later. She kept working after her husband was elected governor of Arkansas. She would become the first lady to do so.
I suppose I could have stayed home and baked cookies and had tea.
Then came Washington.
This health security card will represent a right of every citizen, and it will give each of us the security of knowing we will be taken care of when we need help.
Her health care initiative came crashing down in 1994. Her high visibility came at a cost, but the superwoman learned to steel herself in the face of repeated controversy. There was the unexplained suicide of White House counsel Vince Foster and questions about the Clintons' Whitewater land deal. But the challenges didn't end there.
I did not have sexual relations with that woman, Ms. Lewinsky.
The affair and the House vote after that to impeach her husband threatened to derail Team Clinton. But Hillary was nothing if not resilient. She ran for Congress and was elected senator from New York with 56% of the vote. She became the first lady to enter Congress. And in 2007, another first.
When people tell me, well, you know, I don't think a woman can be elected president, I said, well, I don't believe that, but we're going to find out.
She became Hillary, like Shakira or Cher. It showed independence. It was a hard-fought campaign against Barack Obama, but Hillary never backed down.
Shame on you, Barack Obama.
Even when campaigning got ugly. Not long after that, Clinton welled up at the New Hampshire diner and ran away with the primary, another victory. But in the end, she conceded, wrapping up her historic presidential bid.
Although we weren't able to shatter that highest, hardest glass ceiling this time.
But her persistence and passion convinced the man she tried to beat to cast her on the world stage.
In her, you will have a Secretary of State who has my full confidence.
The former First Lady and Senator from New York would become Madam Secretary in 2009. Yet now, a millionaire miles and 112 countries later, she finds herself entangled in one final controversy.
I'm in charge of the State Department, 60,000 plus people all over the world, 275 posts.
Testifying about who knew what when, in light of the attack on the compound in Benghazi. But if history is any guide, Hillary Clinton may emerge unscathed once again and reinvent herself. And Hillary's close friends say when it comes to her future, she isn't rushing to make any decisions, Wolf. She is not going to do this on anyone else's timetable. And that sounds just like Hillary Clinton.
Yeah, she did not back down at all during, what, 5.5 hours of testimony before the House and Senate committees. Excellent work. Thanks very much, Randy, for that report.
Hillary Clinton will be sitting down with President Obama today for their first ever joint interview, which is scheduled to air on Sunday. Who would have thought that 4 years ago? They have been 4 successful years for her, but now she's getting ready to step down as Secretary of State.
We're all getting a little emotional and sentimental around here with about a little over a week to go in my tenure.
Secretary Clinton made those comments during the launch of a nonprofit organization yesterday, capping off a busy but also contentious week. You couldn't help but notice during her grueling day of questions on Capitol Hill Wednesday just how savvy she was, deferential to some senators, combative with others, perhaps with an eye on 2016. Joining me now is White House Managing Editor for National Journal, Matthew Cooper. Good to see you, Matthew. Good morning.
Thanks, Chris.
First, let me ask you about the Clinton-Obama 60 Minutes interview. Politico notes it will be not only the first joint interview for the two, but it's also the first sit-down TV interview the president has given with anyone but Michelle Obama. So how big a deal is this, and what should we be looking for, you think?
Well, I think you'll want to look at the body language between them. I think they've developed a great working relationship after battling each other in the 2008 campaign. And I think you'll look for them to project a very strong message to the world, especially Iran, North Korea, and other perceived threats around the globe.
Yeah, that they're going to ask him, would you vote for her in 2016? So that's the question I'm waiting for. Let's talk about Secretary Clinton's testimony on Benghazi. You write this would be her last scandal, with scandal in quotation marks. Talk about that, Matthew.
Well, ever since she and Bill Clinton got to Washington in 1993, there's been one scandal in quotation marks after another, most of which have proven to be not really scandalous at all. There was, the suicide of her friend and former law partner Vince Foster, who's the White House counsel. Big investigation into whether anything nefarious happened there. Turned out it was nothing but his very sad depression. Whitewater, lots of other things, just didn't really pan out in a way that stopped her from going on to be elected twice as a U.S. Senator from New York and from nearly getting the Democratic nomination in 2008 and being Secretary of State. So my point in the piece in National Journal was that if you keep crying wolf essentially about someone, it's very hard for the 39th time you do it for it to stick.
Not only that, but she's obviously gotten very practiced at how to deal with these kinds of situations, although she did become emotional when talking about those killed in the Benghazi consulate, including Ambassador Chris Stevens. Let me play that.
For me, this is not just a matter of policy, it's personal. I stood next to President Obama as the Marines carried those flag-draped caskets off the plane at Andrews. I put my arms around the mothers and fathers, the sisters and brothers, the sons and daughters, and the wives left alone to raise their children.
And then Senator Ron Johnson, who she had a fire exchange with later, suggested maybe she faked her emotion to avoid answering his questions, just as some suggested she was faking her illness when she actually ended up in the hospital. Is this sort of anti-Hillary 2016 already underway?
It's certainly, anti-Hillary. I don't think it really behooved the Republicans well to go down that particular road. They never really got a good narrative line on the Benghazi tragedy. First, they kind of suggested that the administration had covered up the origins of the tragedy in order to somehow help them in the election. That always had odd logic to me, because normally an attack on Americans might actually help the incumbent party. Be that as it may, then their argument kind of morphed into incompetence. They never really sort of had an argument they were driving towards yesterday, and thus, for that reason, many others, especially Secretary Clinton appointing a blue ribbon panel to investigate the tragedy in Benghazi, she came out pretty well.
Yeah, and let me ask you finally, because we're all looking ahead to see will she or won't she in 2016. How have these last 4 years not just changed her, but changed the kind of candidate she would be and her prospects for winning this time around?
Well, I think it's only enhanced a blue chip resume. The two elections from New York for Senate capped a very long run and unique path-breaking run as First Lady. I think she's gotten wide praise for her helm at the State Department. So it's really raised her from being a big national figure to a truly global figure. And so if she decides at close to age 70 that she wants to run, she'll obviously be a very, very formidable candidate.
You want to place bets? What do you think the chances are?
At the Defense Department today, former Secretary of State Hillary Clinton was awarded the Pentagon's highest recognition for public service by the Chairman of the Joint Chiefs, General Martin Dempsey, and Defense Secretary Leon Panetta. Clinton thanked the group for her Valentine's Day gift. We should note also, for the first time since her accident in December, Clinton did not have to wear those corrective lenses she'd been using for impaired vision from her fall. In the years ahead, we will be looking to all of you and to your successors to carry this mission of American leadership forward, to keep our nation strong, free, and exceptional. I am so grateful that we've had a chance to contribute in each of our ways to making our country and our world stronger, safer, fairer, and better.
But as CNN political editor Paul Steinhauser explains, the hot topic is what could happen in 4 years.
Hey, Miguel, you know, it's the biggest question in presidential politics. Will she run? The she, of course, is now former Secretary of State Hillary Clinton. When asked at a global town hall a few days ago if she was thinking of making another bid for the White House, this was her answer.
I am not thinking about anything like that right now.
And here's what she said the same day in an interview with CNN.
Have you decided that you absolutely will not run?
Well, I have absolutely no plans to run.
No plans, but she isn't closing the door. Clinton's returning to private life with some poll numbers any politician would love. Nearly 7 in 10 in a recent NBC Wall Street Journal poll said they approved of the job she was doing as America's top diplomat. And 2/3 in a recent ABC Washington Post survey said they had a favorable impression of her. Clinton shouldn't be in any rush to make up her mind, says Democratic strategist and CNN contributor Paul Begala, who was a top political advisor to President Bill Clinton.
She's not going to commit to running when I think in her heart she has not decided to. And she's got the time, she's got the support. There's no need to rush into 2016.
If she does run, our own CNN ORC poll indicates the obvious. She'd be the front runner for the Democratic presidential nomination. But we're getting ahead of ourselves. Let's let Clinton enjoy some downtime. At least for a month or two.
Hillary Clinton gave a lot of CEOs a reason to believe that they could compete.
Exactly. You know, this is essentially about Hillary Clinton negotiating what it means to be Secretary of State in a time when the U.S. is arguably more economically vulnerable than it's ever been. And she comes into office, and one of the first things she and her aides told me was that she saw, you know, all these foreign heads of state going to bat for their companies. You know, Angela Merkel taking almost 24 CEOs to China. You know, you can't imagine President Obama doing that.
Right.
So she's looking at this and saying, well, what can I do? You know, I'm a former presidential candidate, first lady, senator, I'm a superstar, and what can I do? And, you know, then it turns out that she has gone to bat for dozens of companies and helped them seal billions of dollars worth of deals.
There's one thing Democrats and Republicans can agree on. As of today, Hillary Clinton would be an unstoppable candidate if she runs for president in 2016.
Elise, you travel with the Secretary of State, you watch her work, you see the pace she keeps. This is a tireless woman, not used to slowing down.
Definitely not, Don. This is a woman who we can't even keep up with her. There's the pace that she goes, especially on the road, but also here in Washington, is really relentless. There is, it's not someone who just flies and meets in a foreign ministry with a leader or a president and has a dinner. This is someone who's constantly going on the road, meeting with civil society groups, meeting with opposition groups, having town halls. Someone who really doesn't slow down. And, you know, the last few years, Secretary Clinton always has been someone that keeps a frantic pace, even when she was first lady, when she was senator. But the last few years, Don, she's really been going at a kind of frantic pace. They call her the ever-ready bunny.
After logging more than 950,000 miles, visiting 112 countries, Hillary Clinton is known for keeping a grueling schedule and enjoys something rarely seen anymore in politics, a huge approval rating, close to 70%.
She is tireless and extraordinary.
It's because I think she works hard, she does a good job, she really cares, she authentically cares, and she has, I think, devoted her whole life to this set of issues.
You know, the journalists that travel with her can't even keep up with her. She's always, you know, got some other group to visit, some other place to go, some other event. And sometimes we could travel to 3 countries in a day. I mean, this is someone who really puts the pedal to the metal. I think just the pace of the last 4 months, you know, everyone's been wondering, is she going to run for president in 2016? And when you ask her whether she's going to, she says, I mean, a lot of people don't necessarily believe her, but she says no. And I think one of the things is that even if she believes it right now, I think a lot of people think she just needs some rest. She needs to slow down. And there have been people that have been worried about the kind of the pace that she's taking, because this is not someone who's saying, no, I can't do that. This is someone who, to her staff, is saying, come on, we can fit one more thing in. We can fit one more meeting in. We can fit one more country in. Sometimes I travel to 3 countries in a day with Secretary Clinton.
She is hugely popular, both here and abroad. When asked today about the number of goodwill get well messages the Secretary Clinton has been sent following her illness, a spokeswoman at the State Department said it has been a tsunami of messages.
Yeah, she's very popular, not only in the United States, but around the world.
Absolutely right.
And she's been, I think, to almost every country in the world.
Paul Bogali even told me today he thinks she's the most recognizable face, female face, especially coming from our country and around the world.
Yeah, well, we wish her the best.
We do.
Well, Secretary Clinton was, you know, as you well know, she really moved. She was constantly on the go. She never stopped. She went to all these countries. I think she broke all sorts of records. I know that Madeleine Albright and Condoleezza Rice and Colin Powell, they traveled a lot as Secretary of State. But I think Hillary Clinton broke all sorts of records, and she worked really hard. And I had a chance to spend a little time on one of those trips. She went to France, then Egypt, then Tunisia. I accompanied her on her plane, watch what was going on. She was nonstop. She took that kind of aggressive, nonstop travel from her, to a certain degree, from her husband, the former President Bill Clinton. I traveled with him all the time, and he was nonstop as well. He used to do day trips. We used to joke to Bosnia or Kosovo or whatever, and Hillary Clinton was like that. She moved, she moved, she moved.
And we know as well, Secretary Clinton, when she was the First Lady, traveled quite a bit as well around the world.
Now, a lot going on today. Here are some things we thought you should know. President Obama and Hillary Clinton are the most admired man and woman in the world, according to an annual Gallup poll. This is the 11th year in a row that Hillary Clinton has topped the most admired list.
Well, Hillary Clinton says she insists that she wants to get out of politics.
Yeah.
But a new poll is showing that the majority of Americans are hoping she has a change of heart. The latest ABC News Washington Post poll shows 57% of Americans would vote for Hillary Clinton in 2016. Hillary Clinton also has a strong bit of support in her home state of New York, where 54% of voters say she'd make a great runner. But New Yorkers aren't so enthusiastic about the current governor jumping to the race. Just 39% support Andrew Cuomo's 2016 presidential bid.
Also, it was back to work Monday for Secretary of State Hillary Clinton, and her warm welcome is our favorite story of the day. There it is.
That's right. After a month of health problems, including a fall, a concussion, and a blood clot, Clinton got a standing ovation from about 75 staffers at the State Department.
And they had a little fun at her expense, too, which I thought was kind of funny. They gave her a few presents, a helmet, actually, with the State Department seal on it, and also a football jersey with her name and the number 112, as you see right there. That's the number of countries she has visited as Secretary of State. Almost a million miles traveled in that job. The most traveled Secretary of State in the history of the country.
Tom Nides gave her, you see there, regulation helmet, football helmet, stamped with the State Department seal, because, of course, life in Washington is, in fact, a contact sport. And to make the uniform complete, a jersey with the words Clinton and 112, and the number 112. That's, of course, the number of countries that Secretary Clinton has visited as Secretary of State, a world indoor and outdoor record.
To Hillary Clinton, keep fighting for us. TeHillaryClinton.com.
I would change, because you're amazing, just the way you are. And when you
quite an accomplishment. And today, Secretary of State Hillary Clinton made her first public comment since returning to work after treatment for a concussion and blood clot in her head. She's leaving the State Department soon, but sidestepped a question about retirement.
It's, obviously somewhat bittersweet, because I've had the most extraordinary experience, and I work with just an amazing team of people. But I'm very much looking forward to doing everything we can these last few weeks to resolve and finish up wherever possible, and then to, you know, have a very smooth, seamless transition to Senator Kerry to continue the work.
And then retiring?
Well, I don't know if that's the word I would use, but certainly stepping off the very fast track for a little while.
We shall see.
Last night, President Obama said goodbye and thank you to Hillary Clinton, and he chose to do it quietly on 60 Minutes, knowing that that would create even more talk about Hillary running for president in 2016, which is what we're going to do next.
As deep as the GOP bench?
Absolutely. It's strange. I think Hillary Clinton is by far the most likely nominee for either party to be for presidential nominee in 2016. Republicans have a lot of sort of B candidates or B minus candidates who are very interesting. Yeah. Democrats have none. I mean, is it Antonio Villaraigosa? I don't really. Is it Debbie Wasserman Schultz? I don't think so. Joe Biden? I mean, I think people are
America's
delusional.
Happy warrior.
He's a super happy warrior. He's been running for president for 1,000 years. He's not going to win, right? So I think the Democrats have a bench problem right now, and it's serious, but they do have a clear frontrunner, I think.
All right. Thank you so much.
I am very proud to have been Secretary of State. I will miss you. I will probably be dialing ops just to talk. I will wonder what you all are doing, because I know that because of your efforts day after day, we are making a real difference. But I leave this department confident.
Just moments ago, Hillary Clinton formally wrapped up her run as Secretary of State, the most traveled in history. She said a final farewell to her State Department colleagues, although there really aren't that many out there who believe she has said a final farewell to politics. Newsweek's cover story calls Clinton the most powerful woman in American history. How's that for an endorsement? So a big farewell in Washington today.
Here's your first look at this morning's dish of scrambled politics. The latest Gallup poll finds Americans still don't like Congress very much. Only 15% approve of the job that lawmakers are doing. That's up 1 point from last month. The second-ranking Democrat in the House, Maryland Congressman Steny Hoyer, says in his opinion, the 2016 presidential race is easy to predict. He says if Hillary Clinton decides to run, she would clear the field and, quote, "I don't know that anybody would run against Hillary."